this is a dependent motion. Now this is a pulley of radius r, and these are two weights. Now we have to find out the relation between its velocity with respect to this and its acceleration with respect to this. Now let us take, this is in this direction, this is xa, and here it is in this direction, this xb. Now you know the it is this string over this is inextensible, it will not extend. Okay, so the length of the string is constant. Is it okay? So that was that is the starting point of this solution. Now let us take from this point to this point is d. So xa, xb are variable, d is constant. Okay, so what is the length? Xa minus d is this one up to from here to here, plus pi r here to here, then here to here is xb minus d. Okay, so xa minus d plus pi r plus xd xb minus d is equal to some length. This is a constant. Okay, this is constant, this is constant, r is constant, pi is constant, okay, d is constant. So from here, if you take a time derivative, so xa plus xb, xa dot plus xb dot is equal to 0. So that means velocity of this a plus velocity of this velocity of b is equal to 0. Okay, so you differentiate this one again with time derivative, so the acceleration of a and acceleration b, you add it, this will be 0. This is the starting point. Now you see physically what will happen. The velocity of xa, if it is upward, this will be downward. That's why these two addition is 0. That means xa dot is equal to minus xb dot. Similarly, this one. Okay. This is the fundamental starting point. This is actually a general type of method. And if the weight of these two are given, then you can find out the numerical value of this expression. I mean xa, xb, xb dot and all this. Now you see the second problem. You draw the problem first. You see from here we have taken x dot dot, x dot double dot, these are all positive in this direction. Now similarly, 1, 2, 3 weights are there. There are two pulleys of radius. First one, this one is R1, this radius is R2. So previous one, X1 is this one, D is this one, XP is from this point to this point, this point to this point is X3. Okay, what we have to find out? We have to find out the accelerations of all this. First of all, we find out the relation of the acceleration, x1 double dot plus x2 double dot plus x3 double dot. x2 is this one. So to write down the problem first, a system of weights and pulleys is arranged in a vertical plane as shown in the figure 2, this figure. Neglecting friction and the inertia of the pulleys, find the acceleration of each weight if the ratio of these masses m1 is to m2 is to m3 is equal to 3 is to 2 is to 1. Okay. M1 is this one, m2 this one, m3 this one. These are the masses ratios are given. Okay. So similarly, we start with this. The length of this up to this is constant. So what will happen? You see x1 minus d means this one plus pi r1 plus this means xp plus d plus this means xp plus xp. So you see x1 minus d plus pi r1 plus xp, okay, it is a constant one. Okay, so here if d is constant, r1 is constant, xp is not constant. Okay, so xp is variable, so you do it x1 dash plus xp dash is equal to 0. This is the equation number 1. Okay. Then for that x2 part means this x2, from here to here x2, so x2 minus xp plus d whole bracket plus pi r2 plus this one x3 minus xp plus d is equal to constant. Now we have done it, x2 minus xp plus d plus pi r2 plus x3 minus xp plus d is equal to constant. Okay, so this is the, you can arrange this one like this. Okay, so this equation you have got x2 that's velocity x2 into weights number 2 weights x2 that minus 2xp plus x3 that is equal to 0. So this is the equation number 2. Now from this equation xp can be found out. So you put it here in xp, x2 dash minus 2 into, okay, is equal to 0. So this equation we have got ultimately in the terms of velocity, x2 dash plus 2x1 dash plus x3 dash dot is equal to 0. This is the number 3a equation, 3a. And if you acceleration, is the 3b. Okay. Okay. So x2 dot double dot plus 2x1 double dot plus x3 dot double dot is equal to 0. This is a 3b equation number 3b. Okay. These are the required relationship. Okay. Between the velocity and between the velocities and also accelerations. Okay. Now let us come to the D'Alembert principle. Here one is let us assume one is having a tension T1 in this direction. Here it has got the tension in this direction T1. Okay, so this one also will be T1. So we have assumed this is T2 and this is T2 also. So this T1 will be 2T2. Now you see, this is very easily understandable. Okay, the tension on the weight 1, this is M1 is the mass of the weight 1, and G is the gravity force in downward, and this one, please note that we have used this system for the D'Alembert principle dynamic equilibrium. You can use Newton's second law of motion or third law of also Newton's laws of motion, actually second law. So this direction will be in the opposite. This will be the acceleration force, inertia force. This will be in the downward for if you take the Newton's, and in the upward if you take the dynamic equilibrium, this will be upward. So this system is in dynamic equilibrium. Similarly 3. Now you see, we have taken this is T2, this is also T2. It is of course obvious. If this is the tension here, T2, this will be also T2. Okay. And this is T1. So T1 is equal to 2T2, obviously. Okay. So this is this. This is this. This is this. Now from this, we can come to these equations. T1 plus M1 X1 double dot minus M1G is equal to 0. This is the fourth equation. This is T2 plus M2 X2 double dot plus M2G is equal to 0. This is the second, fifth equation. T2 plus M2 X2 X3 double dot minus M3G is equal to 0. This is the number 6th equation. And this is T1 will be equal to 2T2. This is the 7th equation. Now all the equation, if you solve it, it will take much time. But after solving, you will get X1 double dot and acceleration of the weight 1 is equal to g by 17. G is 9.81, okay, meter per second square. So x2 double dot is equal to 5g by 17. x3 double dot is equal to minus 7g by 17. Okay. Okay. If x1 acceleration of these two is upward, this will be downward. If these two are downward, this will be upward. This is the meaning of this. So, please.